one could almost take the example of what happens in Silicon Valley, for example, as a model and think about what's the equivalent of that for the kind of African entrepreneurs we're talking about. So let me tell you what I mean by that. Very often, entrepreneurs in Silicon Valley, they already live in an ecosystem, and it's a very dense and very engaged ecosystem. Question is, how do you recreate that when you've got entrepreneurs who are spread out across Africa, when there isn't quite yet a Silicon Valley? Now, some of that is happening through the various hubs that are being created, whether it's in Nigeria or in Kenya or in South Africa or Zimbabwe. I mean, those hubs are interesting ways to create these dense places where there's a lot of those connections. So that's one model we could try and benefit from. The other is also to provide the kind of, beyond the mentorship, behind the kind of validation that often these young entrepreneurs actually need. So, for example, to the extent that we have people connected to Harambe who are well-placed, they can provide an incredible sort of validation. So if you happen to, if you have somebody, for example, who knows executives at pick your favorite venture capital firm in the Valley, I think, an introduction of a young Harambean entrepreneur to those circles is helpful. And somebody who's well-placed can make that validation by the mere effect of the introduction. If you have a young Harambean, for example, who's trying to do something connected to a very large company, somebody who can provide that validation. Because one of the things that I've found, especially when it comes to Africa these days, is that you've got, there are clearly a lot of people trying to be entrepreneurial. That's a good thing. Very often, the people on the other side of that who could either make those ventures happen, either private equity firms or venture capital firms or even corporates, have no way of validating which one of these it is. Is it this one? Is it that one? How do I know this is a good idea? How do I understand this individual and their backgrounds? So often, if there's somebody who can play the role of validator, because I find that often I'm asked quite a lot of, okay, so which entrepreneurs do you like in Africa? Not because I'm an expert, but because quite often people are asking me that, know me, and so therefore, presumably if I can say, oh, this is a good idea, listen to it, that's helpful, versus something. So I think quite often this notion of validators may actually be the bottleneck between connecting great entrepreneurs, of which there's a growing number in Africa, and people on the other side of that who can be facilitators or platforms to enable those initiatives that the entrepreneurs are pursuing. And that's a bottleneck we're going to have to solve.